Can't cover everything. So what we'll be doing in this final section is we will be playing a game. We will be opening this up for all other Premier League fans on our website www.premierleaguemuseum.com as well pretty soon. But just to give you a preview, this is a game that we will be playing with the three of you, where we'll be predicting how and why each of the clubs will be placing themselves in either the Champions spot or the Europa League. So that completes our Champions League spots and probably more stories associated with it in terms of the sackings that we potentially are going to see. Does this mean Pochettino is going to come in? Who knows? So one last before we move to the delicious relegation zone. The Europa League, the sure shot Europa League, the sixth spot. We know that seventh spot, like in the current season, can go to FA Cup winner as well. So one spot typically is what is guaranteed for Europa League. The other spot, we never know what is going to happen. Who will be the taker of the Europa League? And let's start this time with Sarthak Sharma. Let's just do around the table.
Yeah, so we're predicting just one team, or you want me to pick two?
Just one team. Just one team, which is just, sure shot. Yep.
Just one team for me would be Arsenal. I think, we've talked about the good work that Mikel Arteta has done since he's come in. And there's a project there. For the first time in Arsenal, in a long time, I think since the early days of Arsene Wenger, I can see that there is a genuine interest among the players to be a part of a project which they think will go far. I still feel, and this is why I didn't pick Arsenal to be a part of the top four, I still feel like they're a little bit short in some areas, which will come. This is the same thing with Ole Gunnar Solskjaer when he came in at Manchester United. This was the first season that you felt he needed time to build his team. The same thing with Jurgen Klopp when he came in at Liverpool as well. New managers, especially young managers, need time to build their squads according to the way they want it to be. Which is why I feel like Arsenal probably won't make it to top four, but I still think they have enough to make it to Europa League. And with if Aubameyang, with him set to sign a new contract, that's a huge bonus for them. It's a huge plus. I think he'll be the game changer next season. And most definitely, Arsenal for me will be top five, if not top four.
Amazing. All right. Thank you, Sarthak Sharma. Sarthak Mondal.
Well, I will go for a bit of a bold prediction here. Okay. I will go with Leeds United.
Really?
Yes, wow. I will go with Leeds United. I've seen quite a bit of them in the Championship in the last two seasons. And if Patrick Bamford does not play, which is a very big ask, they have the potential to surprise quite a few teams in and around them with the likes of the players they have got. And they are coming into the Premier League as a better team than Sheffield United has came up last year, in my opinion. I mean, let's be honest, even though I have a soft corner for Sheffield United because I live just behind Bramall Lane, mm-hmm. and have watched them in League One and Championship, but the likes of Jamie Shackleton, Calvin Phillips, Pablo Hernandez, Luke Ayling, Stuart Dallas, they are slightly better than the likes of George Baldock and company.
Quite interesting. And I think that's the biggest surprise factor that people have started talking about. What side of Bielsa will we get to see in Premier League? We know that he's pretty explosive. He's pretty. He does a pretty good PR for himself. And the question is exactly how will it come up in the Premier League?
And there is another reason why I said it, because even though Leeds are not a big club now in terms of financial standards, but they are a very big club when it comes to history. Mm-hmm. In terms of the rivalry, as you can say, Leeds are probably the only big city in the UK that has a single club. So that is where they get their slogan from, that we are all Leeds, aren't we? Yeah. And I think that they will be the surprise package of this season. And they will definitely not get relegated. But I think if I have selected Leeds United there because I expect Tottenham to kind of qualify via the Europa League positions.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So Leeds United will be my bet.
Interesting, very interesting, and that's quite a bold. I gotta laud you for that. Pretty bold bet with Leeds. All right. Thanks, Sarthak. Saumil.
If there is only one team that I have to pick for the Europa League spot, I think it will be Leicester. I think they ran out of steam because of, you know, basically having a very small squad last season, and I think they'll be once again doing well this year. So I think they'll do that. I agree with Sarthak. Tottenham is going to win the Europa League, the biggest European trophy ever there is to be won, and that will be won by Jose Mourinho. So I think that will be fine. But yes, Leicester, they not a lot of people are talking about it, and I think that will suit Brendan Rodgers. I think he thinks he's, you know, a really big elite manager, but I think he's done best when, you know, people are not talking about him and the club. So I think, considering the fact that Maddison will be staying, there was a lot of rumors last year as well. So, you know, Maddison will be staying. They've got a brilliant, you know, young core of the team. And I think Vardy still has got it. We just saw last season. So I think they are going to be there and thereabouts. So if there is one team to be picked to finish in the Europa League spot, I think it will be Leicester.
But only challenge that I see, according to me, for Leicester is that they are going to be participating in the Europa League. Do they have big enough a squad to be focusing on both stages, the Europa League as well as the Premier League? Because we know how taxing for a team like Wolves, this was an extreme to handle this season. Obviously, they did pretty well to go get to the quarterfinals and lost to the eventual winner Sevilla. But do they really have it to, you know, pull off in the two different tournaments?
I think it is easier for a club like Leicester, who are in Europa League, like compared to a bigger club, to be honest. Because when a bigger club like United or, you know, Chelsea goes into Europa League, people expect them to win. Leicester can basically put out an under-23 or under-21 side throughout the Europa League campaign, and people won't really complain because there are limitations that people are aware of. So there isn't that pressure for Rodgers to play his first team and succeed in Europa League. If he gets to the knockouts, he can prioritize Europa League at that point, as it will be a big thing for them to win. But I don't think Leicester will be playing the likes of Vardy and Maddison and all these players when they play away at some, you know, European away tie. So I don't think they'll be focusing on Europa League at all. I think another year in Europe would be something that would be financially big for them. But because I'm sure Sarthak will be able to give more details on that. But they have been betting hugely financially in the last couple of years. They have been taking out loans from an Australian sponsor. They have basically got money borrowed till for that 2023 season's revenues as well. So, you know, for
yes,
them, staying in some sort of a European competition is very important. They've got a brilliant but an expensive, training facility, academy revamp as well. And they are not owned by an owner that's going to put in unlimited money. They are a very well-run business. So I think for them, the target will be stay in the Europa League positions and see where the Europa League fixtures go.
Quite interesting. Cool. Thank you, Saumil. Just to round up from my perspective, I think this will be Chelsea's spot. I think, like I said, they will still miss out on the top four. There will be some turmoil, but eventually they will come back. We shouldn't be surprised. And as you can see, also, I have discounted Manchester United as well, because I think this season is where Manchester United and Chelsea will be the clubs which will be in a turmoil. It will all depend upon where eventually Mauricio Pochettino decides to go. I think this will be the season when Pochettino probably will be coming back. We thought we may never not see him again in Premier League because Barcelona were looking for a manager as well. Obviously, he regretted his comments about speaking never to coach Barcelona again. But coming back to the Premier League, I think who survives better from the turmoil that happens this season? I think most likely Chelsea, as they have done in the past and they have more experience of handling this kind of turmoil, will do better. And according to me, I think Chelsea will end up in the Europa League spot. So that's something which, again, is my take that Chelsea will get into the Europa League.